I think the patient has an easier time than the family coming to terms with it, right, to letting go. So we make sure first that they have as much time as they want to create an environment within the hospice that the person is familiar with. I remember working with one hospice patient whose daughter was very, very anxious about it's such a foreign environment, and my mother has always been a very home person. So we, I said, well, what were her favorite paintings or calligraphy from the Quran? What gave her comfort? And bring it. And we asked the hospice to be able to put those on the wall, so when the mother was awake, she would look at something familiar, photographs of the grandkids, you know, little things like that that would make it seem like home, away from home. Food, as you were saying, is also another issue. Because of the diet restrictions in Islam, it becomes very necessary that the patient feels that they're getting halal meal, which is what is the dietary restrictions, and to facilitate that, and to be able to bring their favorite food in. Because sometimes families are hesitant to ask. They don't know if this would be received well by the caregivers. You know, and there have been cases, for example, especially for Muslim women, you know, who've lived a modest lifestyle, to make sure that those attending to her are women, right? That for perhaps a sponge bath or something, she may be very hesitant to have a stranger do it, to allow the family member, show them how to do it. So those kind of care is very, very important. And also then the family feels involved. They don't feel like they were abandoned because it was a difficult decision to start with. And also for the patient, because many a times when I've worked with families that were making this decision, it's always the patient saying, I don't want to be a burden. I really do want to go into care. But then you can have the odd person who would say, oh, they don't care about me. So there's a lot of counseling and a lot of mediation that has to take place. Because I think even for palliative to work, both family and patient have to be at peace with it.